Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to be doing a DIY video on these flip-flops that I made. So right now I am in Joann's Fabrics and I'm just showing you guys the different prices for different colors. And as you can see, they're actually out of all the colors that they do have. So make sure you check your store because they may have the color you're looking for if you're not looking for this one. But for me, I wanted to do like this cute little brown. I've seen these shoes going around Instagram. I saw somebody charging $60 for these shoes. Absolutely not. So don't worry, I got your back. We're gonna make it for a free shoe that we already had and $249 on the fabric. So for this project, you're gonna need a hot glue gun. I got this one from Joann and I used a 60% off coupon. You want scissors with a sharp tip, and you're also gonna need some hot glue sticks for the hot glue gun, of course. So I had this old shoe laying around the house, or these pair of shoes, and this is the fabric that I got at Joann. So the first thing you wanna do is stuff the shoe to make sure that it's completely at the size that it's supposed to be. So I just got a scarf that I had laying around in my beauty room, and you want it to sit all the way up, that way when your foot stretches it completely, it won't pull on the fabric. Right now, this is an extra piece that I had left before from when I did the other shoe. So I'm just showing you right now that one piece is enough. Like, you can just do one layer and it's gonna be a cute, fluffy little shoe. But for me, I wanted something that was really extra. If you know me, I'm extra. So I wanted mine to be super fluffy. But I am showing you that one piece is enough. So right now, I'm just doubling the fabric because I want to see how fluffy that's going to be. And that's freaking huge. It's almost ridiculous, which makes it perfect for me. So you want to line up the fabric edge to edge because you want it to be even all the way around. And then you want to measure the fabric against the shoe so you'll see how much fabric you're actually going to need, because you're not going to need the whole thing. But the important step here is kind of measure beyond the shoe. The reason I say this is it's better to have a little bit too much fabric than not enough. So you want it to go just under the shoe just slightly, but don't worry, when we glue it, it's not actually going to go under the shoe. So right now, I'm gonna just put two little slits where I measured that the fabric needs to stop. And I'll show you in a second why I'm doing it that way. So I tried cutting it across like both sides with the scissors on the last pair, and I have fur everywhere. So for that reason, you need scissors with a very sharp tip, because you're just gonna be using the tip of the scissors to cut. You wanna get as close as you can to the fabric and not the fur, and just cut straight across to where that other slit is. The reason I'm cutting it this way is because, like I said before, if you just open the scissors all the way and just chomp straight across, you're gonna cut the fur and it's gonna be choppy, and not to mention it's gonna make a huge mess. This fur is everywhere. So you just wanna use the scissors without opening them too much to stay as close to the fabric as you can. And if you look as I peel it away, you'll see that the fur is just coming apart where I cut it. We don't have any huge chunks missing, and it's a nice clean cut. So right now I'm just adding a bead of glue right in the middle so I don't lose my center point, and basically so the fabric doesn't slide around. So the straight edge of the fabric that you cut is actually going to go towards the foot, and the end that's folded is going to go towards the toe. So you see how we have a nice crisp edge on the ankle part where the top of your foot will be? That's where you want your cut edge. So on the last pair that I did, the last shoe that I did, I actually cut this piece right here off, but it wasn't as fluffy as I wanted it to be. So right now I'm going to line up the edge of the top part to the shoe, but I'm just going to tuck the bottom layer under. And that's what's going to give you that super fluffy shoe. So instead of cutting that piece off, I just folded it under, and now that shoe is so huge compared to the other one, and I absolutely love it. So you want to just kind of measure it to make sure you're not going over the edge of the shoe on this side. Add your hot glue and hold it down in place until it's done. So I started kind of before I got to the bottom and then slid the glue up until I got right at the edge. It's important not to get the glue on the bottom of the edge, because have you ever had like a pebble stuck in your shoes and it was just like bothersome? If you're that type of person who gets bothered by that type of stuff, then you don't want the glue to bleed over to the bottom of the shoe. As long as it's on the side, it's perfectly fine. But if it bleeds to the bottom, it could cause some discomfort when we're in the shoe. So just keep that in mind. And right now I'm just checking to make sure all my edges are lined up, making sure the glue doesn't bleed over, but that it does get to the very edge of the shoe without getting on the bottom of the shoe. The good thing about this glue is it is forgiving while it's wet, so you can still move it around if you need to, but honey, once it's dry, it's over. Like, you can cancel Christmas, it's over. So just hold it in place until it's completely dry, and you need it to be completely dry before moving on to the other side, because you're going to be pulling against that side to make sure it's nice and tight on the other side. And y'all remember how much extra fabric we measured, right? And look how it's coming just right to the edge of the shoe. So I'm just showing you right here what I did on the last shoe. I actually cut that piece off, but we're not going to do that. We're just going to tuck it under. And look how it's just right there at the edge with no extra. That's why I said just measure over more than what you need. And try not to get the glue on the fur. It's really frustrating if you do, and it's kind of hard to get it off. You have to cut it out of the fur. That's the only way to get it off. This is the shoe that we just did, and the one on the left is the first one I did. See the huge difference? And believe it or not, the one on the left is actually two layers. So I tried to fix the one on the left, and it just was not happening for me. This glue is so strong, I could not get it off. I tried cutting it off, pulling it off, none of it was working. Like, the glue is extremely strong, not to mention I used a lot of it because I didn't want my shoe to break. If you look here, I'm literally tearing the whole shoe apart. Like, the glue was not having it. So I decided to just leave it and thin the other shoe to match that one, because it was really the only option I had. Look at that. Look. That glue is the strongest glue I've ever used. And this is it, in case you're interested. It was $8 at Joann without a discount. So that's it. That's the finished product. You just made some DIY fur slippers for close to nothing. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to dream big, love hard, make mistakes, and have no regrets. Give me a big thumbs up if you like this video, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye.